Time for some live chat questions. The first one comes in from Sandy. It says, I love my family doctor, but he's Hindu. Is it wrong for me to go to a Hindu doctor? Do I have to find a Christian doctor? Terry, what do you think about that one?
Well, I actually had an Indian doctor for a long time. And I mean, Jesus says we're to be in the world, but not of the world. And he was a wonderful man, a fabulous doctor. And we had many spiritual discussions together. You know, I think mm-hmm. we're supposed to engage people in our walk on a regular basis. And it was never an issue for me that he didn't share the same faith that I did. Today, he's retired. Today, I have a doctor who shares the same faith. And we talk about missions and all kinds of things. But, you know, I think we need to engage the people that come into our lives in whatever arena as friends, mm-hmm. you know, to embrace the gift of life we have together and the journey that we're on and share the things of our heart with each other. Yeah, what do you think?
I think it's fine. Why would there be anything wrong with, you know?
We're not to be set apart and not willing to know or love or touch or, you know, live amongst people who are different than we.
It's always good to know that whoever's giving you medical care is praying for you.
Yes.
But I wouldn't say it's wrong to do others. All right.
Hey, this is Melissa who says, I homeschool my son. We were going to read Huck Finn together, but I'm disturbed by the use of the N-word. Still, the book has a wonderful message, and I don't want him to miss out on a classic. What do you think I should do?
Melissa, that's one of the classics of American literature. I would encourage you, yeah, read that. Tom Sawyer. I'm a real fan of Mark Twain. He wasn't a believer either. He has one of his critiques of Christianity is quite scathing,
but a great opportunity for discussion. You know, when you're homeschooling, that's to me the plus and the benefit of all of that is you get to take something like a classic and then sit and talk with your child about your values and you know what was happening when that book was being written, but how the world functions today and what's right, what's wrong, what we do, what we don't do. It's a great opportunity.
Well, Huck Finn is one of the classics because it takes on prejudice and does so using the language of the day and the way that language dehumanized people. And it is brilliantly done. And I would highly recommend it. So
I agree. Right.
Here's another question. Is it possible to sell your soul to the devil? If I say I'd sell my soul for fame or riches or whatever, does that stick? And they don't want to leave their name either. That's enough.
Well, I mean, I don't know what you think about that. I think it's a short-lived sale, can I just say. Bad choice. But I think there have been people historically who, you know, have said, rather than deal with eternity, I want the benefits of the here and now. Does it stick? I mean, this is what I know about Jesus. He loves you. He paid the price for your soul. He's always there. I think it's pretty scary to wait until the 11th hour to decide you want to follow him. But but does it stick? God's redemption is always available.
Yeah,
what do you think?
He paid the price.
Yeah.
You are redeemed. Realize that. You've been bought with a price. And his price outweighs whatever bargain you think you've done. We've all sinned. We've all followed our own desires and have those desires lead us away from God. But the great news, Jesus paid the price. He bought us back.